Minun nimeni on Paula. Hauska tutustua. Hi, hey. I'm Paula. Nice
Minun
to meet you.
Nimeni on hey. Paula.
Minun nimeni
Öska
on Paula. Hauska
tua.
Tutustua.
Tutustua.
Let's go through this. Start by saying, hey,
hey.
Minun nimeni on. Then
minun
say your name.
Nimeni on.
Hey, minun nimeni on Paula. Finally, say, hauska tutustua.
Öska
hey,
tutustua.
Minun nimeni on Paula. Hauska tutustua.
You're going too fast for me.
And now let's see the same sentence in formal speech.
Formal.
Hyvää päivää.
Hyvää
minun nimeni
päivää.
On Paula Laamonen. Hauska tutustua.
Minin.
Good day. My name is Paula Laamonen. Nice to meet you.
Nimeni on Paula.
Hyvää päivää.
Laamonen.
Minun nimeni on Paula Laamonen. Hauska tutustua.
Tutustua.
So what has changed from the previous introduction? Let's take
I
a close
a
look
clue.
At these together. Hey has been substituted with the formal
Hyvä.
Greeting. Hyvää päivää.
Hyvä päivä.
Finish for a good day. Minun nimeni on Paula. Has not been
minun
changed.
Nimeni
in both cases,
on Paula.
Minun nimeni on means
minun
my name is.
Nimeni
However,
on
during a formal
Hilton.
House introduction, we also say our last name. So I said, Paula Laamonen. Here you would say your full name. Finally, hauska tutustua is the same for both. This phrase means, nice to meet you.
Ah.
One more time.
Tustua.
The informal way to introduce yourself in Finnish is Hey, minun nimeni on Paula. Hauska tutustua. You can make
tustua.
It more formal by saying
Öska
Hyvää päivää. Minun nimeni on Paula Laamonen. Hauska tutustua.
Päivä.
Now it's time for Paula's points. When you introduce yourself, it's a good habit to shake hands and use Hauska tutustua after saying your name. If you're concerned about politeness, even hey is polite enough in the Finnish business world.
Hey!
In fact,
asshole.
If you speak too formally, people will think you sound unnatural. In Finland, simple is best.
C'est moi.
In the last lesson, we learned how to introduce ourselves in Finnish.
Yeah.
In this lesson, we're going to learn how to properly thank people. Are you ready?
She's
then
cute,
let's start.
Isn't she? She's cute. Have a look at cute.
There are several ways to
cute.
Thank someone, but
there
let's start with the easiest. It's just one word.
Hello.
Kiitos.
Kiitos. I know that word.
Kiitos means thank you.
Dioch.
When saying thank you very much,
Dioch
you just need to add the word paljon.
Kiitos,
kiitos paljon. Kiitos paljon.
Kiitos paljon.
Paljon means a lot.
A lot.
So kiitos paljon is just like saying
like
thank you very much. It doesn't matter if you're trying to be formal or informal. Kiitos will work in both situations, so don't worry. But how do you reply to thank you in Finnish? It's easy. There are basically two ways to do it. The first is ole hyvä.
Ole hyvä.
Ole hyvä.
Ole hyvä.
Ole hyvä literally means be good,
be good.
And it's commonly used to reply to thank you.
Kiitos.
Especially when someone thanks you for giving them something. The other way to say you're welcome is the expression ei se mitään. Ei se mitään.
Ei se mitään.
Literally, this phrase means nothing or never mind. You use this when you think that there's no need to be thanked. So it's like saying, don't mention it. So when someone says kiitos to you, you can simply reply with ole hyvä or ei se mitään.
Kiitos.
Now it's time for Paula's points. If you're not sure about whether to use kiitos or kiitos paljon, keeping it simple is always your safest bet.
So just
you don't have to worry about formal or informal situations. Kiitos can be used with just about anyone, anywhere, and at any time.
Like a martini.
In the last lesson, we learned how to thank people by saying kiitos. In this lesson,
kiitos.
We learned some of the most common greetings used in Finland. Ready?
Moi.
Let's get started. The most used informal greeting is hey.
Hey.
Hey. Hey
no,
means
moi.
Hi or hello.
Ah.
We use it when we meet people, friends, relatives, and even people we don't know. We used this phrase in lesson one. Do you remember? Do you also remember what the formal way of greeting people is?
No.
Hyvää päivää.
Ah.
Hyvää päivää.
Hyvää päivää.
Literally, hyvää päivää means good day. As a rule of thumb, we can use hyvää päivää only during the daytime,
oh.
From midday until early evening. During the evening, we say hyvää iltaa. Hyvää iltaa. Ilta is Finnish for evening, so hyvää iltaa means good evening. Hyvää päivää and hyvää iltaa are used when we meet someone, but when we leave, we don't say these greetings again. Instead, when living in a formal situation, Finnish people say 나케민. 나케민. 나케민 means goodbye. In informal situations, you can just say hei hei.
Hei!
Hei hei.
Vittu sinut!
Finally, in Finnish we have an expression meaning see you soon, which can be either formal or
informal. Norsu! Elefant!
Nähdään pian.
Nimeni
on. Now you can greet people in many different ways in Finnish. Let's review them all again. When greeting someone in an informal situation,
hei.
Hei. When greeting someone in a formal situation, hyvää päivää.
Hyvää päivää.
Hyvää iltaa.
Hyvää iltaa.
When leaving in a formal situation, näkemiin. When leaving in an informal situation, hei hei. When leaving, no matter whether it's a formal or informal situation, nähdään pian. It's easy, right?
No.
Now it's time for Paula's points. In formal situations, Finnish people commonly greet each other by shaking hands. But if we meet someone we are very friendly
very
with, we hug each other. Don't be afraid to do it with your Finnish friends. It's normal. In the last lesson, we learned the most common forms of greetings in Finnish. Do you remember them? In this lesson, we're going to learn a very useful phrase. Do you speak English? If you find yourself in a situation where you need assistance in English, this phrase can be a lifesaver. And because you're asking it in Finnish, you can be sure that everyone will understand what you're saying, even if their answer is no. Here's the informal way to say it. Puhutko sinä englantia? Puhutko sinä englantia? In Finnish, verbs change depending on the pronoun that is used. This verb, puhua, is conjugated to the second person singular, puhut. Ko is a suffix used to make it a question. It is similar to the English word do here. Puhut refers to sinä,
puhut,
which is the informal way to say you. And I'm sure you recognize englantia as English. Puhutko sinä englantia?
Oh, you can say it so easy.
To learn how to properly conjugate Finnish verbs like puhua, please look at our Absolute Beginner series on finnishpod101.com. There you'll find several detailed grammar lessons. We're now going to make this sentence formal. First, we need to use the formal version of you, which is te. If we change the word for you, we will conjugate puhua differently. It becomes puhutte.
Puhutte.
Everything else stays the same.
Puhutteko
te englantia? Puhutteko te englantia?
Englantia.
Adding anteeksi, excuse me,
anteeksi,
makes the sentence even
that
more polite.
Greek.
Anteeksi, puhutteko te englantia?
Anteeksi.
The responses you will receive could be one of these three. Kyllä.
Puhutteko
kyllä
te englantia?
Vähän. A little. Vähän.
Kyllä.
Ei, en puhu englantia. No, I don't speak English. Ei, en puhu englantia.
Englantia.
Since this last one is a negative statement, we need to say ei first,
ei,
then en before the verb, puhu. And englantia after
englantia.
Notice also that the verb
puhu
is slightly different than puhutte.
No.
Remember,